Welcome to Microbiology for Nurses video series, and this video we will discuss about transport and culture media. So what is media? It's an ingredient which is kept for the growth of bacteria. The culture media is otherwise called as growth media, which is used for the growth of microorganism, whereas transport media is the media used to transport the samples from one place to another. There are different types of culture media. According to the consistency, they are classified as liquid media, semi-solid media and solid media. And based on their ingredients, they are classified as simple media, complex media, synthetic media and special media. Based on their oxygen requirements, they are divided as aerobic media and anaerobic media. So what is a liquid media? It has no agar and used for inoculum, and it is inoculum and blood culture. So if you are going to collect the blood culture, we need a liquid media where the bacteria can stay safe inside the culture bottle. The example is nutrient broth. The semi-solid media has 0.5% agar, which is the best media for motility of bacteria. So motility medium is an example of semi-solid media. The solid media contains 2% of agar, and it is mostly used to colonize the bacteria and to study the morphology and pigmentation of the microorganism. The example is nutrient agar and blood agar. So what is this agar? This agar, you all know, it's a jelly like substance which is even we are used in the food, like agar agar. So it creates, when it mix with water, it becomes a jelly substance. That's why in liquid media there is no agar, semi-solid media there is only 0.5% agar, and solid media contains 2% agar. So according to the ingredients, it is classified as simple media. So what is simple media? It is otherwise called as basal media, most commonly used in routine diagnostics of microorganisms. Nutrient broth, which consists of peptone water, meat extract, sodium chloride and water, which is a basal media. Nutrient broth is a basic media, where in this nutrient broth they can add glucose agar or nutrient agar, which is called a simple media. What is complex media? Along with this basal media, if you add any extracts, extra ingredients, then we say it as complex media, like yeast extract or casein hydrolysate. These kind of substance will be added with the simple media, that is nutrient broth, which makes it into a complex media. What is synthetic media? These are made of chemical substance, which are the exact composition we are not aware, used for the special studies. Example is peptone water. So what is simple media? It's a basal media, that is nutrient broth. If you add anything to the simple media, we say it as complex media. Synthetic media are used, made of chemical substances and used for special studies. What is enriched media? So there is enriched media and enrichment medium. So what is enriched media? Substances like blood, egg, serum are added to basal media. We say it as enriched media. So the bacteria can grow faster and their natural nutritional need. So if we add blood, egg or serum to the basal media, we say it as enriched media. The best example is blood agar or chocolate agar. These are all the plates which are having blood agar and chocolate agar, culture plates. The next one is enrichment media. So enrichment media is a liquid media. It stimulates specific bacterial growth from the mixed growth. So if there are two different types of bacteria grows, and one bacteria you want it to grow better, the other one you don't want, so in that case we add enrichment media, which will stimulate the specific bacterial growth, inhibits the unwanted bacterial growth. The media is added with substances which will suppress the growth of unwanted bacteria. So here there is an example of selenite F broth, which is specially made for the growth of Salmonella and Shigella species. So you want the Salmonella to grow faster, then we use selenite F broth. Alkaline peptone water, which is enrichment media for Vibrio cholerae. So when you use alkaline peptone water, the Vibrio cholerae will grow faster than the other bacteria, so which will help in the benefit of understanding the bacteria. The next one is selective media. There are specific medias which are used only for certain specific microorganisms. We say it as selective medias. This also plays an inhibitory role of that other media. This increases the growth of desired bacteria and suppress the growth of the undesired bacteria. The best examples are McConkey gram-negative bacteria. Here there is a McConkey plate where there is growth of gram-negative bacteria is observed. TCBS for Vibrio cholerae. This plate with green, here you can see the Vibrio cholerae, which is nicely grown in the TCBS media. The next is LG medium, where the tuberculosis microorganisms grow. So selective bacteria, which you can use it only in the case of selectively growing microorganisms. The best example is McConkey is used for gram-negative bacteria, TCBS is used for Vibrio cholerae, and LG medium is used for Mycobacterium tuberculosis. The next is differential media. The ingredients in this media will help to distinguish the bacteria from the others. So it will differentiate the microorganism from the other microorganism. The best example is McConkey medium, where the lactose, where it gives the difference between the gram positive and gram negative. So it gives a difference between lactose and non-lactose fermenters. So it is made of peptone, lactose, agar, neutral red, and taurocholate. So here you can see this pink strikes causes lactose positive, that is gram negative bacteria, and those the unchanged strikes are lactose negative, that is gram positive bacteria. So what is transport media? Media used for transporting the samples are called transport media. These delicate microorganisms will not survive the time taken for transporting for specimens from one place to another place. So they are transported in a media where they can survive. For example, you are taking a sample from the client in a hospital and you are transporting it to the lab, or maybe in a other special lab in another place. So you need a transporting media so that the bacteria will survive during that transporting time. The best example here, you can see whatever swab you are taking, you remember that when you put it inside, there is a jelly thing substance which is kept in the sample tube. So this is agar, which is used as a transport media. The steward medium, which is soft agar gel, which are used for gonococci, and buffered glycerol saline is used in case of enteric bacilli. So the very common gel is soft agar gel is used for the transport media. So this is a video where we discussed about different types of culture media with example and transport media. Thank you. Once again, see you in next video.